What's up, everyone? Welcome to the 7,000 subscriber Q&A. Well, it's now 7,100, but you know, the subscriber count is going so fast I don't even know what to call it anymore. Anyway, let's just dive right into it. How did you meet Gypsy? Gypsy is someone that I met actually through Twitter. I remember this pretty well. He used to like a lot of my videos, and at some point I was like, you know, hey man, I see you like a lot of my stuff, you know, appreciate it and all that stuff. I saw he did some videos as well, and then, like, you know, I was like, okay, you know, I'll have a look at it. And then, you know, I saw some rants about, you know, those YouTubers, and like, hey, you know, I agree with that, so I followed him, and it kind of just went from there, really. It's funny though, because when we met, I think we had either he had less subs than me, or we had around the same amount of subs. I think it was around 3,000 at that point. He now has like, I think, nearly 40,000, and I'm still like 7k. I don't know, that dude had some great success over the past few months, so it's very cool. And another thing, a lot of people were asking, for the Q&A at least, were asking about the future of the top 3. I touched on it a little bit during the last episode last week. I'm still like kind of figuring this thing out. The current plan, like I said in that episode, is very simple, is that I just simply I'm going to try and live stream it on Twitch, and I make like a YouTube video out of it, like on the same day as usual, I suppose. I don't know how I'm gonna do it yet. Gonna have a little bit more time to think about it. I'm not gonna do another top 3 type of thing for a few weeks for sure, because I kind of just want to take a break from the whole thing, you know, take a break and all that stuff. I'm kind of like now enjoying the fact that, you know, I actually have a Friday night to myself. So yeah, whenever I have the actually concrete plans, I'll do a video on it, you know, with like the top 3 plan. I'll probably even call it that and just let everyone know what's gonna happen. If you want to follow me on Twitch, there'll be a link in the description. I do regular live streams now as well. I try to live stream on Tuesdays and Thursdays at 7 p.m. UK time. So if you're interested in that, feel free to give me a follow. Or just stay following me on Twitter. You know, it's basically the same thing. I just announce it there or even on YouTube. It's not always going to be GTA. I think last time I streamed on Tuesday, I was streaming some Tomb Raider. Actually got a good response from that too. It was fun, you know, just chilling and hanging out. It's kind of the main goal of the streams to me. It's always just, you know, chilling and hanging out and not going too crazy. You're not going to bleach your ears. Just throw on some song requests, listen to some music, play some games, and having some fun. Really, that's all it's all about for me. And then Mr. Meanly asks, do you think Rockstar will make us wait another 3 years till we hear anything about the next GTA, seeing as Red Dead Redemption 2, Red Dead 3, is coming next? Well, what I personally think, Red Dead 3 is probably going to be the new focus for probably a year or two. I don't think we're going to hear about a new GTA for a while, especially because GTA 5 is still so, you know, very popular and very active, especially GTA Online. Game is still selling well, and I, you know, obviously they're working on it. The gap between GTA 5 and GTA 4 was like 5 years, so I'm suspecting it will be at least that long. We're currently in year 3, so we're nearing on 4 years of GTA 5 in September, so I don't know. No, you know, with Red Dead rolling around, you're probably gonna have to wait a few more years, which is kind of crazy though, because GTA 5 has been out for over 3 years now, which is a long as fucking time. Doesn't even feel like 3 years. Where are you from and how old are you? Well, for the first part of the question, I have this very cringy song. I'm from Holland. Where the fuck you from? And for the second question, I used to have this very bad meme, but unfortunately 21 doesn't work anymore. So if you ask my fans, or whatever you want to call them, I'm apparently a 42-year-old virgin. If you would ask me, that would mean that I'm 22. Another question about Red Dead 3 is that, do you think we'll be getting a second and possibly more revealing trailer for Red Dead 3 soon? Possibly. I don't think it's going to be a while though. Probably a bit more, I guess, you know, when they're kind of more done with GTA Online. I think as soon as we're getting more information about Red Dead 3, I think GTA Online is going to slow down. We're already in 2017, and I'm kind of expecting that, you know, they're probably going to slow down a bit with the DLC, like they're already doing now. They're now doing 2-week event weeks. They're slowly drip feeding us those new cars, like the Itala GB, and I think the Spectre is going to be next on Tuesday, and it's going to be, you know, probably waiting until Valentine's is what everyone's expecting, and then we're gonna get a Valentine's update, and I think we're going to kind of get a repeat of what happened last year, that those first few months of the year are going to be pretty slow, which I kind of didn't really enjoy too much, but it's okay. You know, gives us time to stack up on some cash. Like at the moment, stunt races are a great way to make some money. After I'm done with this video, I'm probably going to play some more because I haven't really had time that much this week, unfortunately. Work has been pretty crazy. I think whenever we do, I'm really looking forward to what we're going to hear about Red 3. There's a lot of questions I have. You know, we have some answers, but also at the same time we don't, because obviously leaks are not really something to be trusted. How did you get that smooth, sexy voice? The thing is, I get this a lot. A lot of people apparently like my voice. Personally, I'm not really a big fan of it. I kind of think it's kind of boring and dull, but I guess, you know, if you want some of it, I can give it to you if you want, really.
You want some of this?
That was both very cringy and creepy, so have fun with that. Now, this wasn't really like a Q&A question, but I figured I'd answer it anyway. Someone was asking if what the background music was. There's a link in the description always from the channel where I get all the background music from. It's a great channel. Basically, just, you know, extracts all the songs that you just play in, like adversary modes and stuff like that. It just extracts them from the PC's version of the game. So if you're looking for some unique and new GTA music, like from the soundtrack, that's a channel to be. Basically, in the description, it says just music with a link next to it. If you go to that channel, you'll be busy for a few hours because there's some great stuff on there. And it's perfect for background in videos, for sure. Jay asks, who is your favorite GTA protagonist and why? Well, the thing is, this is something that I always get, right? What's your favorite GTA? What's your favorite city? What's your favorite that? Like, all these favorite GTA type of things. And I never am able to answer them. But personally, I like this question because I'm actually going to answer it like this. I don't necessarily have a favorite GTA protagonist because I feel like what makes GTA games great are the side characters, like Little Jacob, like Roman, like, you know, Ken Rosenberg, like Ryder, like Big Smoke, you know, all those people, just to name a few, like, before I list them all, right? There are so many great characters, like, for example, GTA 3, perfect example. Cloud doesn't say shit, but all those side characters are all interesting. No, the mission givers, like, you know, for example, if you see Little Jacob arguing with Elizabeth, or, you know, or you see him arguing with Batman, for example, it's just like those, the connection between the side characters and the protagonist are always great. Like, I mean, Nico, for example, is someone I really, really enjoy. But at the same time, there's also something very cool about Tommy Vercetti. That's the thing. It's every character has something. And it's the same thing for me with GTA games. When I think about GTA 4, I think of, like, a very strong story. I think about, you know, like a more serious, grittier type of vibe of the game, and I really dig the vibe. But think about, for example, Liberty Rock Radio, which is one of my favorite radio stations of all time. If I think about Vice City Stories, I think about, you know, the brothership between Vic fans and Lance fans, and I think about V-Rock, which is, that is something that's actually my favorite radio station in GTA. GTA Vice City V-Rock. And the main reason for that, because like the whole thing between Cousin Ed and Laszlo, where it just basically goes like, knives are cool, rock is cool, Cousin Ed is cool, Laszlo sucks, I love sluts. You know, it's fucking fantastic. I even have, I think, an entire video dedicated to all those voiceovers, which I may or may not have edited on a shitty laptop during college when I should have been doing work. Good time. Do you prefer Watch Dogs or Mafia 3? I'm gonna go for Mafia 3. The main reason for that is that I really, really enjoyed the vibe of Mafia 3 a lot more. It felt a lot more like alive, and the city felt a lot more breathing. Yes, the stories were pretty linear and like kind of, you know, kind of you got to deal with it after a while. But same thing with Watch Dogs, really. But Watch Dogs kind of felt a bit dead to me, especially when it comes to the world. And I think especially the music in Mafia 3, whenever you were driving the cars, that definitely helped the vibe as well. Like, there's so many songs on there that I'm a big fan of, you know, House of the Rising Sun, just to name one. So many great stuff in there. Especially if you're someone that likes that type of period of music, you're gonna feast your eyes. I really, really enjoyed the vibe of the game. But, you know, yeah, sure. The story was okay enough. But, you know, I thought Lincoln Clay was an interesting character too. It's not the most fantastic game, but I did really enjoy my time in there. And then Gypsy asks, what do you think that happened to Mom's blender at the end of San Andreas? That's actually, I think he's trying to make the entire meme, and I think he even, you know, tweeted that flying kitten dude that makes all these crazy YouTube poop video, I think they're called. It's actually like the one of those things that you don't really think about when you're playing, and then just, you know, randomly brings it up. It's probably sold for crack money or something like that. I don't know. I really like what they did when they, in San Andreas with the whole riot mission, where basically after that everyone's so pissed off. I also remember when I did one playthrough on San Andreas with cheats, and I activated the riot cheat. That was messy. You couldn't turn it off, which is really, really difficult to start doing all kinds of stuff then. Because, oh man, if you activated riot cheat code, you might as well just turn off your game. It becomes a riot, fucking chaos. What are the first kind of games you ever played, and what is your favorite game? The first game I actually ever played was on a Game Boy Color, and it was Pokemon Blue. Before GTA, there was Pokemon Man, I guess. It's a very stupid thing I just said. But basically, up until I was 10 years old, I played Pokemon exclusively. I basically didn't do anything else. But then my cousin gave me a legally downloaded version of San Andreas, and then I played that on my dad's PC, and then I kind of never really looked back. Then I bought a PlayStation 2 because Liberty City Stories came out, and it kind of just went from there, to be honest. Then I played Vice City Stories, then went back. The rest is pretty much history, really. And obviously my favorite game is GTA. And if you're interested, there's other franchises that I really, really enjoy. Killzone being the second one. Uncharted is the Naughty Dog games are something that I really, really do admire as well. Big Battlefield fan. Although I don't play it, you know, extremely often. Mainly because I just, you know, it's one of those games that you just really have to, like, have a group of friends together to actually play it. Because it's not really a solo type of game. It's not really like Call of Duty. You just pop it in and just play a few rounds and log off again. And especially time being a thing, you know. GTA kind of still, especially because there's now stunt race, double money. I really like the idea of earning a lot of money by winning as much races as possible. Not saying that I win everything, because, you know, slipstream and catch up is still a thing. That shit pisses me the fuck off. And then over here we have a gentleman asking me when I will reply to his friend request on PSN. Now, there's the main reason I picked this question as well, is because I kind of want to throw it out there as well, is that over the past few weeks or months or whatever, I've had some really fucking terrible experiences with adding people on PSN. I've basically sat in parties getting entire fucking, you know, 3-hour Q&A session and shit. I don't really, you know, want to spend my time like that. We can play. Sure thing we do. There's a link in the description that I'll throw in there if you want to join the crew. You'll be more than happy, or more than welcome, to join even. And then you'll be able to play alongside of me, you know, during whatever I do. Whenever I invite crew to something, maybe I'll do a playlist during a stream or anything like that. The only thing I ask you to do is not to be a dick. It's very simple. If we're playing, for example, something like GFED or, you know, along the side of that, if you decide to fuck everything up, I'm just simply gonna ban you from it. You know, we're here to have fun, and, you know, I'm not the type of dude that's just gonna sit there and cry, you know, not be like a Mr. Boss, like, who is that? Kick him from the crew! I want him out of here! He is not nice! No, simply, it's gonna be very, very, you know, simple. If you decide to start killing everyone during a GTA race, I'll just tell everyone to go kill you and drop your KD by 50. Simple. You know, I'll make you leave the session. No, but seriously, we're just here to have some fun. That's the main reason I kind of stopped adding people on PSN. I'm satisfied with the people I'm surrounded with now, and I just kind of feel like, you know, I don't know you. That's the issue, is that I don't know who you are. I don't know what you're like. And I don't feel like spending hours upon hours sitting in a party answering all the questions you've ever had about me. I guess that's where this Q&A is for. So don't take it personally. We'll definitely will play at some point. You know, I'll be streaming it. I'll be all kinds of stuff during, you know, live streams. You can ask me stuff and all that stuff. But I'm just kind of cautious about it nowadays, to be honest, because of all the things that have happened. I know I'm only 7K, but and it's probably only going to get worse, but hey, don't take it the wrong way. I just, in the end, this is still a hobby. It's something I do for fun. I don't really make any money off it. It's not my job. I just come home, make a few videos, and whenever I turn on my PS4, I turn it on because I am done with working. I'm looking to relax and have a good time. I don't look to, be spammed with party invites and shit like that and be like, "Hey man, I want attention. Can you give me attention, please?" Like, no, thanks. I just want to relax, have some fun. And if you're a cool, relaxed type of dude, we happen to play one time. I think your cool, relaxed dude is not gonna ask me questions for 5 hours straight. I might at you. But until then, please keep in mind that your friend request that you sent is probably going to stay unanswered. Another question by our homeboy, MC Busby Rock Incorporated. The man, the myth, the legend, the rapper of the greatest diss track of all time, the Gypsy diss track. Oh boy, that was an adventure, wasn't it? How many dislikes does this have now? Let me look this up. Let me just look this up live. Let's have a look how many dislikes this has at this point. Oh, whopping 67 dislikes. I love it. People did not have a good time with that one. But when it comes to my favorite type of music, my favorite band has to be Pink Floyd. It's just fucking, it's brilliant. It's genius music. It used to be my favorite band, used to be Guns N' Roses, but then I found out about Pink Floyd. Never looked back. Best fucking band of all time. The lyrics, just the. I don't know, it's funny because I used to be like really into like metal, like hard rock, that type of stuff. Old school still, not the type of shit. I'm not a fan of the whole death metal kind of thing. I think music nowadays is really, really crappy. I've done a video on that before. I'm probably not linking below because it's terrible. But I don't know, like I really just I enjoy the old school stuff, like Pink Floyd. It's very funny because I go from like something like Pink Floyd all the way to Slayer, right? But it's still old school. Like, for example, like today I was listening to Megadeth, to Pink Floyd. It just goes all over the place. It's still old school. My favorite time period for music is probably the 70s for those wondering. So I guess that sort of kind of answers your question. In regards to why, it just feels good. I grew up with it. And if Francis has a suggestion for 10K, don't sing, please. Well, since I'm at 7K, I'm just going to sing right now. Francis is a scumbag, and he is from Finland. Perkele! There you go, song for your Francis. Have fun with it.